What's up, y'all? It's been a while. It's been quite a while. Weather has went and got nice, and I haven't been doing a lot of maintenance. I had to do brake lines, wheel bearings, brake shoes, rotors, ball joints, oil changes, all that boring, you know, maintenance stuff. And today, well, today I'm finally getting into some fun things. Oh, remind me, I gotta show you what I did to this thing. You know what? I'll just do it right now. How about that? Just go ahead and... Congratulations, you have a horn. Bear with me a moment. I'm gonna get this thing fired up. Because I need to hook up the trailer anyway. I'll be loading that the Sunbird up there is going on a trailer, getting it ready to scrap it. It's probably gonna be loud. Ended up replacing this clamp with a little bit smaller one. They're holding up well. Thermostat's been good. I went ahead and I got a Gates. It's a Gates Fleetline belt. And they didn't actually make one for my application, so what I did was I bought the correct size and an 8-rib belt, and I cut 2 of the ribs off. That's working just fine. So I got rid of that second alternator that I never even got around to wiring up. So it's out of there now. The best part, radio. The best part is now no more squeak. So we'll let this thing warm up. I think I'm gonna get a couple more of those Gates belts, because I can actually have 2 right here on the power steering. You can see how there's 1 missing. So I think I'm gonna put 2 of them on there. I just think it'll look a little better. And I'll never have to worry about the power steering pump slipping. But that's the goal. I wanna get this ugly old beater on that trailer. I wanna cut the rear axle out of it, because I have a idea for a small yard trailer out of, I don't know if you can see it, but in here there's a bunch of steel. It's off of that old trailer that I cut down for some reason. I don't know. But I've been starting to load this thing already. I knocked the windows out of it here because I don't want broken glass all over the trailer. So what I did was I took that trampoline top over there and I stuck it over the car and knocked the windows in. While I was at it, I went ahead and sliced my hand really deep. To be honest, I was surprised that it sealed up, but I, you know, kind of pinched it together, and after a day or so it had sealed enough that it's been working fine. It hasn't split open on me, so yeah, whatever. I probably should have got stitches. Oh, what's that? All them new parts for the van. Because I'm planning on getting this thing put together today. We're going to test fit them new wheels. Hopefully they'll be able to turn. If you don't even know what I'm talking about, I don't blame you. It's been forever since I've even made a video about this thing. But if them wheels don't fit now, we're just going to start trimming stuff, because them wheels are going on this van. This van is getting done this summer. Actually, I want it done by summer. It's been just an all-out race around here with me. It's been every single day of the week. I get home from work and I come out and do stuff for hours. And I ain't letting up. So, I'm gonna go ahead and get this trailer hooked up and stuff, and I'm gonna try to get this thing to start and just drive it onto the trailer. If not, I get the winch. But we're gonna see if we can get it to fire up. It hasn't been started in quite some time, and I'm not 100% that it's even gonna start, because I had to, if you can see, I had to pop the ignition out of it. We had the key. Had the key, it's in it. It would not turn. It just froze up. But anyway, I'm gonna get back to this stuff and we'll check back in. I'll at least throw the camera up somewhere so you can see the car go on it. All right, I'll be back. All right, let's give this another shot. I don't know what's going on. Obviously, I am gonna have to keep messing with this for a little while. If I get it going, I'll be back. If not, we'll just be dragging it on there. I had to show you guys this just in case it actually works. I got a piece of tubing connected to some carb cleaner. And it ran out here and it's dumping into the throttle body. I'm using the air filter to make sure the hood doesn't close all the way. And we're just gonna spray it and start it, and hopefully we can keep it going. I don't know if this will work. And believe me, it's just a coincidence that I was watching MacGyver before I came out here. I gotta get this thing lined up better with the trailer. what do you think the odds of this one starting are? Hasn't been fired up in, I don't know how long. I really can't remember. Whenever, I'll have to look. Whenever the last time I updated that, I moved it up here. Oh, I was wrong. I think I said this had 89,000 on it. It has, apparently I can't zoom, it has 87,000 on it. Still has a completely full tank. No, it's going way over full. Great, something's wrong. Well, let's see if it'll start. Pounds of oil pressure. I'm thinking it's coming up on 2 years this thing's been sitting up here. I could be wrong. Good to me. Anybody want a mouse nest? That just blew out of there. Let's see if there's any more in there. Sure, that's awesome to do to a motor that's been sitting. Well, I just blew a whole bunch more out of it. Just like that, we got the new brake lines in. I gotta come up with some bolts for this bracket here. Now it can't come off because you have to turn it completely sideways, so you have to put it in before you even hook up the ends of the line. But there should be a bolt that goes through here into the upper A-frame, so I gotta find, you know, one of them for each side. But we get new upper A-frames, we get the spring spacers in, new calipers, brake shoes, lines, and shocks. And yes, I know these are rusty, but they're not that bad. I mean, no, They'll clean right up as soon as I use the brakes a couple times. I'm not super worried about it. For some reason, this caliper's gold. Whatever. I'll probably do some painting in here with, you know, just some black Rust-Oleum. I'll brush it more than likely. These friggin' wasps are just everywhere. They're coming out of this thing from everywhere. I've already taken out like 3 nests. Still got to put in the sway bar. I still got to bleed these. All I did was gravity bleed them so far. I don't know if I said that. So I'm about to go see if Kristen will come give me a hand and, yeah, get these bled. All right, there it is. Look at the stance on that. It looks like a van with the motor taken out. It's so high in the front. That should work. I don't think I'm going to get to the wheels today, though. But I got these ones on, so about to fire this thing up and throw all these tools in it and go park it down by the house. So when I get home from work, I can mess with this. I mean, I could do it up here, but it just makes it 10 times harder. So you got to drag everything up here. There's, I leave it down by the house. I can just pull it in the garage or work on it right in front of the garage or whatever. Just easier. But we got the Blake. We got the Blakes. We got the brakes bled and should be good to go. I think I may need an alignment. Looks like the wheels are tipped in some at the top. That's no big deal. Take it down and have them shim it up. There's plenty of stud left that they can move that in or out to adjust it. I got the sway bar back in. Right there's my brackets right there that I made for that bull bar for the front of it. That bull bar right there. Now I got another issue. It's been sitting and no power locks, and the windows don't work either. And these are brand new switches. I thought maybe just the switches went. Nope, no such luck. So, I don't know. Another day, another project. Luckily, I got a power probe. Shouldn't be too hard to track it down now. Looks like I got a bee on the inside. Wonder how he got in here. I hope there ain't a nest inside this thing. I mean, inside it. I got a couple wasp nests and stuff out of, like, around these hinges and stuff. Anyway, I'm gonna quit rambling and get this stuff cleaned up and go. So thanks for watching. You know, comment, rate, subscribe, all that happy stuff. And I'll talk to you later.